Freedom Daily News. Disgusting Libs just hacked Melania's private Twitter pics, attack her over what they saw. Melania Trump has been a class act from the very start of the campaign. However, that does not stop people from attacking or especially like liberals and the mainstream media. One way they attack her is by and about her marriage to the president. After hacking her Twitter account, liberals stole some of her pictures and distributed them online. Despite truth being contrary, they depicted her as an imprisoned wife in an abusive relationship. Kate Imbach, who writes for Medium, went over 3 years' worth of pictures that Melania had posted on social media to concoct some type of narrative to make her look bad. First, they called her quiet and an absentee first lady. While simultaneously noting that out of 470 pictures analyzed, there was only one of her and husband and one of her and her son with the president, Barron. 74 photographs were from Trump Tower. 57 were from high and expensive cars. While 67 are from private planes. Imbach claims that Melania is hiding her family because protecting her family to her means hiding the people that she loves. In a few pictures, she is either cut out of it or she is barely seen. Imbach claims that her so-called imprisoned marriage is one of her own creation, one that is self-imposed as compared to one imposed by her husband. Look at some of the pictures that Imbach was referencing. In her article, she wrote, "These photographs were taken by a woman who is shirking the responsibilities of First Lady in favor of suing the Daily Mail over the damage they've done to her brand by claiming she was once an escort, a woman who has the nerve to refuse to leave her home, even though that refusal comes with a $50 million annual government handout for her security costs. These photographs take on a darker edge. They appear to be the documentation of changing seasons by a doomed recluse. Let the world fall down around her, she's not going anywhere." She went on to say, "Why won't the First Lady show up for her job? Why? I became obsessed with this question and eventually looked to Melania's Twitter history for answers. I noticed that in the three-year period between June 3, 2012 and June 11, 2015, she tweeted 470 photos which she appeared to have taken herself. I examine these photographs as though they were a body of work. Everyone has an eye, whether or not we see ourselves as photographers. What we choose to photograph and how we frame subjects always reveals a little about how we perceive the world. For someone like Melania, media-trained, controlled and cloistered, her collection of Twitter photography provides an otherwise unavailable view into the reality of her existence. Nowhere else, certainly not in interviews or public appearances, is her guard so far down. What is that reality? She is Rapunzel with no prince and no hair, locked in a tower of her own volition, and delighted with the predictability and repetition of her own captivity." Melania posted 5 photographs of Trump with their son. She took each photo from behind the two, sometimes literally from the back seat. Boys in front, girls in the back, the same arrangement we were also appalled to see on Inauguration Day, is her norm. She lives in the background. If Melania sees her family from behind, she sees the rest of the world from above. She posted 74 photographs of the view from her home in Trump Tower. She stays at home a lot, or what seems like a lot for someone with $1 billion and a private jet, anyway, enough to capture the same view, over and over again, at different times of day and weather, ad nauseam. There is a striking passivity to the Trump Tower view photographs. She never changed the composition of these landscapes, she placed no personal mark on them. The time of day changes, she takes a photo, that's it. There is a calmness, a kind of safety, to this approach. The earth moves around the sun, but the photographer is stable, in the exact same position, day after day. Imbach ended her article saying, "We all have a tendency to repeat the same imagery in our photography. It's part of having an eye. But, knowing what we know now, that these photographs were taken by a woman who is shirking the responsibilities of First Lady in favor of suing the Daily Mail over the damage they've done to her brand by claiming she was once an escort, A woman who has the nerve to refuse to leave her home, even though that refusal comes with a $50 million annual government handout for her security costs, these photographs take on a darker edge. They appear to be the documentation of changing seasons by a doomed recluse. Let the world fall down around her, she's not going anywhere. Darker still is that she's in there today, looking down at the rest of us, from her home in Trump Tower, like a queen. These photographs pose another question: if a person spends most of her time looking physically down at the rest of humanity, does she come to take her superiority as a matter of fact? Melania posted 57 photos from inside cars. I first assumed she took the 15 Central Park photos that she posted on foot, from inside the park, meaning that she was going out for a walk among the masses every once in a while. Nope. When you look closely, you can see that tree branches are blurred with the motion of a car, the raindrops are not falling but stuck to a window, and the sunlight is refracted. Her idea of a walk in the park is a drive. Only liberals could take something innocuous and turn it into something terrible. There was nothing wrong with her pictures and social media posts. Clearly, as a high-profile woman, she understands the value of privacy and she should not be slighted for valuing her privacy. There is no way for her to win with them. The only thing she should be is herself. Follow us on Facebook at Freedom Daily. Freedom Daily.